Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain.
Hello, a very good day to you. My name is Sister Temi Tayo. I'm a Christian content creator, and I'm here once again to share from the Open Heavens Daily Devotional compiled by the General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Pastor E.A. Adeboye. And the reason I'm sharing from this particular Christian book is because the Lord instructed me to do so as I prepare to enter into the year 2020. So this is my fourth year of sharing from the Open Heavens. This is why we call it season 4. And all those videos from 2020 are all loaded on my YouTube channel. My handle on YouTube is Temi Agedo, which is right on the screen. I would encourage you to visit my channel, not only to view those old Open Heavens videos, which are a great study guide, but most importantly, to view the Open Heavens devotional for the current day. And I know that will bless you exceedingly. And while you're on my channel, please don't forget to subscribe, and the Lord bless you as you do. Now, Pastor Adeboye led me to Christ in October 1997, a few years back when I was in the University of Lagos, Nigeria. And Pastor gives you a few scriptures from the Bible, a memory verse, and that helps you to understand the body of the text. Praise God. So today is Saturday. I love Saturdays. It's Saturday, November the 11th. And the title of today's daily devotional is Becoming God's Favorite. Becoming God's Favorite. And the scriptural reading today is taken from the book of Psalms. Psalm chapter 42, verses 1 and 2. Just two verses. I read from the traditional King James Version. Psalm 42, verses 1 and 2. And the title again is Becoming God's Favorite. And today is Saturday, November the 11th. And thus goes the reading of God's word. It says, as the hart panted after the water brooks, so panted my soul after thee, O God. My soul thirsted for thee, for the living God. When shall I come and appear before God? Hallelujah. As the hart panted after the water brooks. So what is the hart? The hart is the deer. As he panted after the water brook, so panted my soul after thee, O God. My soul thirsted for thee, for the living God. When shall I come and appear before God? This is the kind of addiction that we must have to the presence of God. You see, God's presence is our hiding place. He's our strong tower. The Bible says that the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into it and they are saved. So, you know, God's presence is my therapy. I'm able to be myself 100% in God's presence. And this was why the psalmist was saying that as the hart. Now, the hart is also the deer in the more modern translation. And what does it mean? It says, as the hart panted forward for the water brooks. Now, the deer has a kind of smell. You know, the bush, in Africa, we say it's the bush meat smell, you know, which the lion can smell from miles and miles away. Now, all the lion needs to do is just follow that trail and it will catch the deer. So the deer is looking for a pool of water because he knows that once he gets into that water, the water will kill the scent of his smell. You know, so he's panting after the water brooks. He knows that the lion will come after him. It's just a matter of time, you know. So he's looking for water brooks where he can dip himself into so that the enemy will not catch him. It says, as the deer panted after the water brooks, so panted my soul after thee. You know, my soul thirsted for God, for the living God. When shall I come and appear before God? And this reminds me of Psalm 27, where it says, when thou seest unto me, seek ye my face. My heart said unto thee, thy face, O Lord, will I seek. You know, so God's presence is our hiding place. We must have an addiction to God. God and his presence should be our only form of addiction, you know. And it's between you and God. And this is why Moses, when he got to the mountain, he stayed there 40 days, you know. That's where our weaknesses die. All our weaknesses die in the presence of God, you know. He's a friend that sticketh closer than a brother. In God's presence is comfort, you know. The Bible says that now thanks be unto God who comforts us in our time of affliction and that we also should comfort those with the same comfort wherein God comforted us when we were afflicted. So there's comfort in the presence of God. It's very difficult to you know, there's The Bible said, the psalmist said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. How amiable are thy courts, O God? Because in the presence of God is fullness of joy, and at his right hand are pleasures evermore. Becoming God's favorite. Amen. And the memory verse is also taken from amongst the verses which we read. It says, as the hart panted after the water brooks, so panted my soul after thee, O God. Parents usually love their children, pastor says, but oftentimes they would have favorites even among them. They may try not to make it obvious, but they know who their favorite is. These are people who, in the same way, they are favorites in the family of God. These are people who please God in every way they can. And one of the major life ambitions of God's favorite is to become intimate with him. So that's the fellowship we have with God. Neither height nor depth nor principality nor power must be able to say nothing should be able to separate us from the presence of God. No man, no woman, nothing, no children, nothing. We must deal with God one-on-one, and this is why Jesus, every time, a great while before Jesus Christ our Lord, a great while before dawn, he will go and kneel before God and pray. We must have an addiction. So pastor is saying that, parents have favorites, and sometimes they try not to make it obvious. But the child that does what the parents want, who is caring and is not a troublemaker, is not giving them any problem, that's the child that they would favor more, They try not to make it obvious. And sometimes, parents make it obvious, which isn't good, because it can cause a jealous sibling rivalry. But that's the same way that God has favorites. There are children of God who do what God likes. For example, Jesus Christ. He was obedient even to the point of death. So he's definitely God's favorite. He's God's favorite. He's our example, and he's God also by himself. So when we do the thing, Jesus Christ said, my Father is with me. He has not left me alone, because I do always the things that please him. And I pray that God will help us to always walk worthy. Amen. In Colossians 1, Paul said that we may be filled with the knowledge of God's will in all wisdom and spiritual understanding, that we may walk worthy of the Lord unto all pleasing, and that's possible because we have the Holy Spirit, that we love God with all our heart, with all our soul, with all our might, with all our strength, and we love our neighbors as ourselves. We do the things that are pleasing. We do the things that are inside the word of God. Now, as I studied this, I remembered the book Hebrews 10:25, it says, do not forsake the gathering together of the saints, as is the manner of some. So what God was saying through the man of God, Paul, is that don't forsake the gathering of the saints, as is the manner of some. In other words, God will say, you see, I have some children. They don't come to church. They don't appear before God. They don't appear before me in Zion. Don't be like them. Do not forsake the gathering together of the saints, as is the manner of this, my other children. So if you want to please God, because God said in his word that we should appear before him in Zion, if you want to please him, then you'll do what he wants. And the Bible says, not by power or by might. And that's why God gave us the Holy Spirit to help us to do always the things that please him. One of the major life ambitions of God's favorite is to become very intimate with him. So we want to pray that the Spirit of God will help us to draw closer to God's word. Job said, and one of the ways that we can please God is by loving his word. Job said, I desire God's word more than my necessary food. He desired God's word more than his necessary food. And that's my portion in Jesus' name. I desire God's word more than my necessary food. Whether you become a favorite of God or not is up to you. It's a matter of what you choose to love or hate. In 1 Corinthians 9:24-27, Paul said that in a race, there are many people running, but only one winner would emerge. The Lord wants you to be the winner. I don't know about you, but I want to be at the forefront of this race. Pastor says, I used to be a runner when I was a little younger, and our coach will always tell us to make sure that we came first. To be number one, you must be willing to pay the price. Amen. You must be willing to pay the price. The price you receive at the end of this race is determined by how willing you are to put your body under now. Okay. So our pastor is taking it in a notch higher. He's saying that we must walk worthy to please God. And sometimes it will cost us. He says you must be willing to pay the price. Sometimes we have to let go of something we love in order to please God. We are choosing between something we love and something and God. You understand? I remember many years ago, this sister, she was from another religion, and she was from another religion, and along the line, she and her brother became born again, and her father was a leader in her other religion, and her husband, who she was married to, was also, you know, they were born into this other religion. But along the line, she met Jesus Christ, she and her junior brother, and the father disowned her, and her husband said, you know, we can't continue like this. Either you abandon Jesus Christ, or you end this marriage, or I'll divorce you as my wife. And she left because she didn't refuse to give up Jesus Christ, and she ended up in the United Kingdom with her brother. But you see, so it cost her marital destiny, because the man said, either you denounce Christ or you remain my wife, but you can't do the two at the same time. And she chose the Lord Jesus Christ. So that is a very high cost to pay. But Jesus Christ paid a bigger cost. That's, you know, and God never forgets. Nothing we do in an attempt to please God will go unrewarded. You know, she chose Jesus Christ. We must always choose Christ. It cost her something, but we know that the price that our Lord paid on the cross, nothing can compare to it. And Pastor says that Paul said in the race that there will always be one winner, and that we must always win. We must be willing to pay the price for God's presence and God's anointing. You see, because when you're walking with God, there's some things you can't do. There are some places you can't go. Some of your old friends whose company you loved so much, because you are now in a different kingdom, you can't hang out with them anymore. You know, and David said, I will not give to the Lord, that will cost me nothing. So it's going to cost you that relationship, but we are willing to pay that price. And the price you receive at the end of this race is determined by how willing you are to put your body under. When it comes to being intimate with God, it is more than what you do in private than in public. In Genesis 39, verses 1 to 9, when Joseph was faced with tremendous pressure from his master's wife to commit adultery, he ran away. He was very committed to honoring God, even in private. By the time you read Genesis 50, 15 to 21, you see that his brothers came to bow before him. Those who want to be intimate with God don't go after public approval and public image. They simply do what God loves, notwithstanding what the public thinks. You know, Pastor says that when Joseph was faced with tremendous pressure from his master's wife to commit adultery, he ran away. He said, how can I do this evil and sin against God? He didn't even say sin against my master. He said sin against God. So God was at his forefront. Meanwhile, this is an opportunity that some other people will grab, and then they will, you know, even insult him that you are stupid, but you know, you are backwards. That's why, you know, you had this. Some people even say it's God that gave you the opportunity to take you out of slavery. But he said, no, how can I do this wickedness and sin against God? And Pastor is saying that before we know what's happening, God lifted his head, you know. And the three Hebrew boys, you know, they said to Nebuchadnezzar, they said, we will not bow. You know, we will not worship your God. We will not bow before you. But our God is well able to deliver us from the furnace and fire. And peradventure, God does not deliver us. We still will not bow. If you do not bow, you will not burn. You know, why were they doing this? They chose God above all else. Chose God above all else. Many years ago, I had a cousin who, in the church where she was, you know, she was dating a leader of one of the cell groups. And, you know, the guy said to her that, I can't marry you unless, you know, we have sexual relations. And she was like, but we're Christians. You are a leader. You're even more of a leader than I am. He said, this is my stand. No, I will not marry you unless we have sexual relations. And she said, no. And he went and he broke the relationship with her. He went and found another sister and they got married, you know. And he was saying, this could be you. This would have been you, you know. So, but I said, you know, it cost her, because, you know, she lost that relationship. And, you know, when the person she married, even after they got married, she was waiting on the Lord for a long time before she got pregnant, you know. But she made sure that in everything, she did not deny God. She stood her ground. Joseph said, how can I do this wickedness and sin against God? And this is how we become God's favorite, when we stand on God's word. Okay, when we walk worthy of God unto all pleasing. In Daniel 1:3a, Daniel and his friends decided not to defile themselves. Excuse me. Daniel and his friends decided not to defile themselves with the king's meat, contrary to public opinion. They must have looked crazy or like fanatics to some people, but they didn't mind. As long as they were not defiling their bodies and God was happy with them, they were satisfied. In return, God made them rulers of all the people when the time came. If you are not willing to count a loss, if you're not willing to count as loss those things that you should have, that should have been gained, so that you can win Christ, you are not willing to become intimate with God. Yes, in you see, so there's a cost, there's a price. You know, Jesus Christ said to us that we must take up our cross and follow him. You say, if any man comes after me and does not hate his brother, his sister, his you know, everything, he cannot be my disciples. He must count the cost, you know. But this Daniel and his three friends, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, you know, the Bible says, and Daniel purposed in his heart that he would not defile himself. They refused to eat of the portion of the king's meat that was sacrificed to idols. They refused to defile themselves because of food. They refused. And people would have said, oh, you know, they were ready to die. Because, you know, if they were given that command to eat and they refused to eat, then, you know, they could have been killed. But they didn't care. They refused to defile themselves. They chose to please God. And God will always remember our labor of love because he's a good and kind God, you know. Pastor says, as long as they, you know, in return, and God will reward. He's a rewarder of them that diligently seek him, that diligently serve him. You know, when Daniel had been thrown into the lion's den, and in the morning, King Darius came to the den of the lions to find out if Daniel had been eaten up alive. He shouted, he said, Daniel, has your God, whom you serve continually, been able to rescue you? And Daniel said, oh, King, live forever. You know, God had sent his angel to shut the mouth of the lions. He rescued and he delivered and he worked signs and wonders in all the earth. You know, because God will always, he will never leave us nor forsake us. He will not give up on us. He will not let us down. He will not lose his hold on us. He swore three times in Hebrews 30. It says, I will not in any way relax my hold on you. And that's how we become favorite. We must always choose God. We must always choose God. If we do not bow, we will not burn. And God will always, he will always reward us for what we have done. And even if he doesn't reward us for it, we will still not defile ourselves and will not deny our Lord Jesus Christ. Reflection, considering your priorities, Pastor says, can you sincerely say that God sees you as one of his favorites? Oh, we are pressing towards the goal of the prize of the upward call of God in Christ Jesus by the power of the Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus. You know, don't give up on God just because what you have been, you think that what you have been asking from God, you have not received it. Don't give up on God. If God doesn't give you the husband or the wife, will he stop being God? Will you deny him because of that and say, oh, because he has not answered my prayer, therefore I will not follow him? No. No, he's God, and God is bigger than what he gives. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you. Thank you for translating us from the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of your dear Son, in whom we have redemption through his blood, even the forgiveness of sins. Father, help us in the name of Jesus by the power of your Holy Spirit to walk worthy of the Lord unto all pleasing all the days of our lives. Help us to be fruitful in every good work in the name of Jesus. Help us to do always the things that please you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you because by your Spirit and by your power and by your blood, we will not miss your appearing in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We thank you for the work of the Holy Spirit in our lives. We ask Almighty God for grace to become addicted to your presence, grace for continuous fellowship with the Holy Spirit and with your word. Because the Bible, Jesus Christ said to us that except we are born of the water and the Spirit, we cannot enter the kingdom of God. Therefore, we are praying for an addiction to your word and a strong and heavy dependence on the power of the Holy Spirit and his presence in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen and amen. Thank you for taking time to listen to me. I hope this blessed you. May God bless you exceedingly for watching this. And while you're on my channel, don't forget to subscribe. I give you permission to share this on your TikTok, on your WhatsApp status, on your, Insta, your Facebook. I give you permission to share it on all social media. And God bless you exceedingly. My name again is Sister Femi Tayo. And don't forget to subscribe. God bless you exceedingly. Have a nice day.